Oh, yes, the Mighty Neil Young and Rocking in the Free World. That was a studio version. You know, I was going to play around with the idea of doing a live version, but having looked at them and found that they were like 12 minutes long, big jams, I thought maybe better not.
Neil Young's got, he's legendary for his long concerts.
I got into him by my dad, because my dad liked sort of country and a bit of folky stuff. And some of the stuff he's done is less rocky than that, but...
he's had three or four phases, yeah. Maybe more.
Three or four midlife crises, probably. But I love that that song, and I think you can definitely see where the grunge came from, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I think that was written about, or released at least originally, about 89, which is about the right time, too. So.
Yeah, and you're going to play us another track now. Track are you going to play?
Well, I'm going to play a song that was originally written for the Temple of the Dog project by Chris Cornell.
Okay.
Actually, it was written by Stone Gossard, the guitarist for Pearl Jam and for Temple of the Dog. And he gave it to Chris Cornell. Cornell threw some lyrics on it. And when around at the same time, they met Eddie Vedder, and Gossard gave the song to Vedder as well, and he wrote some different lyrics to it. So I'm going to do Vedder's version.
Okay.
It's called Footsteps.
Mm-hmm.
And but it's sort of, I see it as a foundational grunge song because it was all part of that, the three bands contributed to it, essentially.
Oh, wow. So, you can't really get more grunge than that.
Yeah.
All right, well, when you're ready.
Okay, yeah, so this was requested by Wade and Mr. Harper.
Okay.
Back in Oz.
Don't even think about reaching me. I won't be home. Don't even think about stopping by. Don't think of me at all. Voices in my head, voices. Oh, I got scratches all over my arms, one for each day since I fell apart. It was you. Footsteps in the hall. It was you. Oh, pictures on my chest. It was you. Oh,
Oh, that's a lovely song, mate. So which album was that from? Which
part? That was the original recording was in the studio around about the time they did 10, but they released it as a B-side. It didn't make the album. It was on the back of Jeremy.
Oh, right. So maybe some people haven't heard that before.
Quite possibly, yeah. It's hidden on there with Yellow Ledbetter.
Well, thank you for playing that for us. We'll go to one of the other pioneers of grunge now, Alice in Chains.